Yo, what's up everybody? It's your boy DC the True. As you guys could tell by the title and the thumbnail, this so-called used to be red pill guy just exposed himself. Let's talk about it. So basically, what we're going to talk about here, this is actually going to be a reaction video, and we're going to talk about this guy by the name of Sublimeconscious. In other words, I've made a video geared toward this guy in the past, and so have other YouTubers. I mean, a lot of them didn't say his name, so to speak, but it was there. Okay, so let's get into the video. Hold on, give me a second here. Now, when I first seen this title, I was like, okay, he finally exposed himself. Let's just get into it real quick. See what he's talking about.
Man, today, by far, would be the most controversial video that I've ever posted on my channel. But at this point, guys, I've gotten to a point where I really don't care anymore. I don't. Because the principalities of darkness, they don't care, guys. The people who are leading you astray and leading you to damnation and to hell, they don't care. And I'm just going to call them by their name. Kevin Samuels, AMS, Alpha Male Strategy, Steph is Cold, Sublimeconscious, Spiritual Soul. These are people that are leading you into damnation, guys. They don't want God's will to shine. They bring you this high-value red pill rhetoric because they want you to fall into the trap that Satan has for you. Satan wants everybody to be led into damnation. He wants to drag as many people down there. He wants to...
Okay, we're going to stop you there before you go any further. Now, this guy himself, he used to so-called make red pill content. And I said, this was back when I had like 300 subscribers. Okay, of course, wasn't nobody paying me attention. It was a video along the line. I don't know if I still got it. If I do, I'll put it up in the corner. But I say it's a lot of people that so-called... in this, you know, I consider myself having a red pill mindset, and I know there's a few females that follow me don't really understand that. But this guy used to make content, and I said myself in that video, I believe I said there's a lot of guys in this community that face the phone. It's not really red pill, and to be honest, I'm not really attacking anybody's sexuality, but I'm like, I don't even think this guy is on that level. He's more of a beta male than anything, because he, even when he used to talk this red pill content, he would bring YouTubers in here, which I'm going to speak on when he brought up Spiritual Soul. So it's not even in this conversation. So that's why I knew how lost this guy was, you know, when it came to this and you in this spectrum. So let's just break the list down. He mentioned Steph is Cold. Okay, to me, if I look at Steph is Cold, Steph is Cold to me is not no a red pill guy, because I mean, I don't know that whole fiasco with whatever he had going on social media, but to me, if you a male, like I say myself, I can switch in between when I'm in single mode or if I'm involved with a woman, I consider myself purple pill. So automatically, if you in any type of relationship, you can have a red pill mindset, but to me, you are purple pill. So, and I know some of you fathers like, man, what the hell is he talking about? The real ones know. Now, Steph is Cold, I don't know. He might have a point with that. I don't really consider Steph red pill as well. AMS, he brought up AMS. AMS on a whole nother level. You could call this man red pill to the core. The man just doesn't believe in relationships, none of that at all. So, but you know, to see, and I'm about to touch on this where he calling people demonic and all this. Oh yeah, yeah. I'm finna touch on you real quick, because I've been waiting to do this. You don't understand. Okay, AMS. Dating shit alone, you take that aside. Based off what he's teaching the better men, as far as like purpose, getting the gym, all that, basically improve, you know, improve, make a better version of yourself. You can't really not what he's doing. Actually, he's probably doing more help than this Christianity journey that you're trying to preach on right now. And I'm going to get into that right now. I'm finna about to drop some spiritual juice on your ass. So, I mean, as far as, you know, AMS, the purpose, you know, he preached, I think that's very helpful to the men that come to him, you know. And I always make jokes like, man, I need to make me a Patreon so I can kind of school some cats out here. Now, he brought up spiritual soul. Spiritual soul is not remotely in the same category as the AMS and the Kevin Samuels. If anything, I think AMS and Kevin Samuels are like the yin and yang in that high value thing. You look at these guys' income or whatever. Yes, they can say, you know, they're like, I wouldn't even say high value. I like you. They're just like a super, I can't think of a word for it. A super financially well off man that has a high value mindset. We'll just put it like that. The money, the financial part can be part of, it's part of that high value too. But you know, you don't necessarily, to me, I don't define it just on income alone. But let's go back to spiritual soul. Like I say, spiritual soul is not even in the same stratosphere as these niggas. He sun gazes, for crying out loud. How the hell you got him over here in the red pill category? This is how confused this nigga is. You go with that, man, focus on DDG and all that or whatever. You point on when you come to him, because he a simp and you is too. So now what I will say about spiritual soul, he was an alpha dog the way he handled DDG ass. We gonna be real. DDG trying to, you know, make brag about hitting the man X in a video, and he was like, she, you know, it basically, in the lack of a better term, she's a thotty. He like, he called DDG a bot. Like, basically, like, bro, you got my leftovers. I'm alpha, you beta. And then last but not least, we're going to touch on Kevin Samuels. Kevin Samuels, the reason, and see, people fail to realize, Kevin Samuel, I watched MTR, I give credit to him. And when he did a video, the evolution of Kevin Samuel, people don't realize Kevin Samuel was riding men for the longest. He didn't get steam until he started having female callers in. Then he got popular because women get in their feelings and y'all made this man blow up the way he is. Good. Now men really got a platform out here. That's y'all fault. Okay. Now back to this guy. Now, when you use terms like demonic and how these guys are misleading people, now you to me, you're talking in the terms of Christianity, so to speak. Let me tell you something about Christianity, the past you finna go down right now, since you so-called, I really didn't never think you was red pill anyway. So at the end of the day, you wouldn't red pill in my book. And any other, I've seen a lot of other red pill content creators sat there and said, it's some guys in this community, hell, I don't even think they let even like women. To be honest, they didn't say your name, but I know exactly who they were talking about. I called you out directly, but I didn't have the subscribers. So we're going to get on you. This spiritual journey you about to take, let me tell you a little something about spirituality. I was on a spiritual journey for 5 years, and let me tell you what it did to me. It kept me broke. It kept me basically like, let's say, you know, we look at the account of Jesus or whatever. Basically said the Son of Man didn't have nowhere to lie his head. Yeah, if I followed that model, yeah, I was a spiritual man, but didn't have shit to provide for anybody. Once I let that go, I started focusing on things. Really, remember, I say I was on YouTube before all that. I let YouTube go for that spirituality. I said, man, if I had kept making videos then, I probably ain't no telling where I would have been now. And so basically what I'm trying to say is, it's like once I, you know, you can have spirituality up here. Once I let go of all the other dogma that go with it, you know, as far as like bettering myself, ain't nothing wrong with that. To bettering yourself as a man, purpose. Jokers like AMS preach that. So there's nothing wrong with that. You sitting there to better yourself so you can provide for your family. When I was that spiritual man, I barely had anything. And the reason I started making progress because I was detaching myself away from that. And I started getting to where I can afford, you know, I can afford a means of living. I can live comfortable. Now, you want to get on that spiritual institution thing or whatever, I'm tell you, the whole back of it, if you really going to follow it to the T, you supposed to be a broke. Ain't that's what, I don't know my scriptures like I used to. There's a passage in there to say, it's easier for a camel to go through a needle pinhole than a rich man to enter the kingdom of God. So when I had that thinking, guess what? It kept me poor. But, you know, I know some of y'all argue with like, well, you're rich spiritually. All this don't mean anything. But yeah, at the end of the day, it still tells you you need to be able to provide for your family. Y'all, I'm sorry for this long video, but I think it was time. I said this was coming. It was time for me to start calling folks like this out. Frauds. And you know what? I'm not even going to play the rest of the video because, like I say, it may seem like I got my own personal vendetta against this guy. But, hey, it is what it is. Y'all, this your boy DC the Truth. I'm finna sign this one out. For real.